We bought a container home from China. Took 3 months to arrive. Folds out to be a 2-bedroom, 1-bathroom, kitchen, and lounge room. Had the whole family to help install it. Used a car jack to level the container on blocks. The roof is supported by gas struts to take a lot of the weight till the walls go up. The floor is on hinges and folds down with adjustable feet. The floor is steel frame and very heavy. Millimeters insulated panels. Now time for the walls to go up that are also on hinges. The container ends then fold out and secured with screws. The floor is gray laminate. Weather seal all the joints. Now have access to the kitchen cabinetry, stone bench tops, and windows. PVC framed and easy to install, 12 windows total. They even come with fly screens. Like and follow for a inside walkthrough.
Hey guys, wanted to show you this shipping container house. I'm in Forest, Virginia, just about 15 minutes from Lynchburg, Virginia. Came up here to stay for a seminar in Richmond, which is 2 hours away, but you know, the container home this close, we've got to check it out. Love the exposed containers on the inside here. Half back to the right there. Really cool kitchen. Dining table. Couch, fireplace, TV. Nice outside space. Go back upstairs. Love the accent wall. Bedroom back here in the back, king size bed. Another outdoor space. This bath here, and your second bedroom, another king bed. Love this home. Can't wait to spend a few minutes and look into the details and figure out some changes I might make on the next build or modify some of these. I don't know. We'll see. Let me know what you guys think.
Drop it. Welcome to our container home here in Sullivan Springs. Just come along with me while I take you for a tour. Here is our small kitchen area for you to see. We have some small cabinet spacing here, and of course, the red fridge. Here is a small living area that goes right into the two-bedded bedroom. We do have this mini split right here in the middle, and here's some decor for you guys to show you that it is a home to be in. Then we go to our restroom with our toilets and cabinet space on top. Then a small sink along with some little storage space in there as well. We have our shower here. Look at that tile. Oof, that's nice. And then we have the bedroom. Also, sliding doors, super cute. And we'll see you guys for the next one. Bye.
Hey everyone, welcome to the Scenic Orchard. Let me give you a tour. This is a 40-foot shipping container that we transformed into a modern getaway. You first enter into the kitchen and the living room, and yes, this is a full kitchen, so you are good to go if you want to cook a ton of meals here. And this is my absolute favorite drawer in the kitchen. And it also has all the cookware and bakeware you may need. So now we're going to head to the opposite end of the container, which has the bedroom and the bathroom. There's also heated floors throughout this whole place. But anyways, here is the walk-in shower, and there's also a bidet on the toilet. And when you come into the bedroom, there is a full queen purple mattress surrounded by beautiful views. And yes, there are blinds on every window. The place was truly inspired by the land that it was built on, so that is why it is called the Scenic Orchard. And now we're going to head outside to the patio. We did just add a projector and screen, so if you want to watch your movies outside, go for it. Also, that fire pit right there weighs 3,000 to 4,000 pounds. We custom built that out of concrete, so it is super heavy. So now we're going to head to the end of the shipping container on the outside where the hot tub is. We do drain, sanitize, and refill this after each guest. Sempre baccalare dal manovene. Se ci picchia quando si è baccalare.
But container home.
Okay, so let me tell you about the coolest Airbnb I have ever stayed at in my life. It's made completely out of shipping containers, as you can see, and this is coming inside. So lots of cool art in here. The owner said that he used to own an art gallery. So this was his collection from, you know, over the years, and there was a lot of really interesting pieces in here, and it was really fun to look at. Some were creepy, I will say, but it was really cool. So this was a living space. And then here we're coming down into the guest bedrooms. So this side is all one shipping container, so you can kind of get the feel for the length of it and the size. I stayed in that bedroom. And then coming down the hallway, you can see here is the bathroom. And then coming into the second guest bedroom, this is where my mom stayed, and she said it was super comfy. And then here we are coming back into the living space. So you can see lots of nice tall ceilings. He actually flipped some of the shipping containers upside down to get those tall ceiling feels. So I thought that was cool. Here was the kitchen. And then we're going to come up the stairs. So the owner had lots of Keith Haring pieces, which I thought was awesome. That was kind of a theme that I noticed in the house. And then here's looking out into the neighborhood. Yeah, it was a very basic Florida neighborhood, and this was kind of like a gem as you drive down the street. So that was fun to see driving up to the house. And then here's the primary bedroom and living space. So just another area, more Keith Haring art, as you can see. And then here's the bathroom. So the bathroom was kind of interesting. It was very open, no door, and yeah, no door to the toilet. So yeah, that was kind of funny. I was with my family, so it wasn't a big deal to us, but yeah. And then here was the primary bedroom. This is where my sister stayed. So cool space. Probably the coolest part, though, was this jukebox that actually worked. We listened to some tunes on there, and that's all.
Good night. Good night.